plus a ticket variance. If you difference mo na, then square then add. So, bakit na ako variance? Kasi sana yung vehicle. Kung ano makuha nyo sa variance, pwede na namin. Okay? Bakit kailangan magulo? Bakit kailangan na expert ka? If hindi natin kasi siya spooner, nagkakaroon ka ng negative value. Nainit ako yung value. Nainit ako yung negative value. Kailangan ka negative value ka. Eventually, pwede mag-cancel out bilang zero value nyo. Pero what if your numbers are negative 100, 0, and 100? Nagmumukha ang variance mo zero pag hindi mo square, di ba? Pero hindi natin ka, nakalaki pa talaga yung variance mo. Malaki, di ba? Something like that. That's the reason why mo square mo siya. To get rid of the negative sign, hindi ka absolute value distance. Na eventually, square mo sa huli kasi yun yung standard deviation. Standard deviation is just the square root of your curve. For sample or sample population or total population na standard deviation. Kung total, inain mo muna yung variance pag mo skinner with pag sample and okay. I'll teach you guys something para hindi na kayo do that. So ito yung diniscuss natin so far. Para lang hindi kayo madudad. Yung function na mo. Pwede ko na yung dito. Why am I teaching it this way? Bakit natapi ko dito? Exactly. Okay. So when I'm teaching you Excel functions, importance in this concept, the hardcore sort of thing is hindi mo siya talaga sobrang kailangan. And during class din naman, I'm not sure for the next term, pero for the next class, pero from our band kasi, our professor was very focused on what is the implication of this, what's the importance of this to business, why do we have to do this, which is ganun talaga yung reason. Hindi man tayo naging stat majors. Same thing. The formula of the median. For mean, hindi mo tinatype median, tapos yung average. Okay. In this scenario, median is smaller or higher than the mean. Smaller, skewed to where ka. That is the median. Another tip, the closer your median is to your mean, the more it will look like that. The more it's closely to another distribution. That's another way of sense checking your data even before you graph each particular point to each other. Pag halos equal ang mean and median, kahit gaano karaming data set yan, it will only look either like this or like this. Pero, already distributed. So yun yung mali yung gawin ko per million yung variance. Sige, since I only have 6 data sets, do you think I should do population or something? So may isa ka eh. Hindi na lang kayo. Based on what you have. I'll show you the difference na natin. So ang sabi ko kanina, pag sample ginamit yung ano mangyari sa denominator, iliit na lang. Pag n minus 1, iliit. So variance mo, lalaki nila. Lalaki. Good. kita naman yung significant difference. Kasi, to begin with, medyo malaki yung variance nila to each other. So, parang medyo pinakalaki pa yung lalo. Then, standard deviation, yun na din. Hindi ka pala, ano, hindi comfortable. Arbitrary ka. Usually, ano daw, I always, personal ako, I usually take it on the same side na regulate the sample, especially the problem states that is the sample. Para from a sample of it, blah, 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 cover the sample, hindi rin ko natin yan. Usually, naman you get, okay, another possible explanation there is, usually, in the real world setting, pag may Philippine sample, or yung sources na rin sa statistics, Philippine statistics something. That's all your data points. So that's the whole thing, that's most likely a population. So it becomes, always becomes relevant. Something. So if you're getting a part lang of that, kaya mas yung ginagawa ng sample. So ganun din dito. First and third tip, I just demonstrate the sample lang kasi ganyan na yung division. Saka suggestion ko in that at least a class, ang main lang din si yung property of yung sample or population or yung unless explicitly level. What is in terms of the formula and standard deviation sample and square root? That's why I explain more variation. The only reason why standard deviation was ginagamit is because squinner was yung variation, diba? You try to take out the negative one. Pero squinner mo siya, so it's an overloaded value. So let's say you measure interval meters. Nagiging meters per sa bigla. Eh kung pinag-measure niya lang yung standard deviation ng yan, kailangan mo balik siya sa meter. Parang ganun na yung logic, parang ipabalik ko lang. Kaya mo siya squinner. From experience naman sa MBA, important, mas important ko, yung alam niyo yung mga formulas na sa Excel. Because hindi naman mag-focus dito yung problem. Mag-focus sila na ako, sige, ano yung na-realize nyo? Based on the time deviation, average, or whatever, what can you conclude? What did you recommend to the business? What should they do? What should they focus on? Okay? Here. Last would be measures of relativity. Okay, invent ako naman. Hindi ba naman relativity talaga siya? Pero kung variance and correlation kasi is usually comparing two data sets with each other. Medyo complicated siya i-solve relative to standard deviation ng variance. Ang covariance kasi, instead of subtracting it to x squared, yung idea, variance and okay, quickly lang sa covariance. Let's say you have two data sets. Ang gagawin mo muna is you get the average of both. Para madali. So you get the average of both. Tapos gagawin mo is, di ba kanya yung ginawa niya? Subtract ko. Instead of squaring it, you multiply it to the subtractor dito, dito. Ano ang pwedeng mangyari doon? Magiging ganun siya. Dito ko pang ilang data ko. Like that x2 and so on and so forth. So, if it's an x-square ka, di mo na-try b sa square, ano mapansin nyo? Pwede ka mag-positive and negative or positive lang? Pwede ka naman negative. Pinaligtad ko to. Pwede ka mag-negative ang value. Kasi, right now, 1 minus 3.5 is negative 2.5. 2 minus 7 is negative 5. Negative times negative, positive. Pero, pinaligtad ko, 2 minus 7 is 5. 5 times negative 2.5. Negative 2.5, negative na siya. So, dun niya makikita, ano yung relevance dun naman? So, may value pa pa rin sa covariance, diba? The value will tell you how big pa rin. Same as variance and how big they are apart. Pero mas importante dito ngayon yung positive or negative siya. Why? It tells you, as one number goes up, as the other goes up, you're going down. Okay? Clear ba? Kaya sabi ko yung measure of relativity, kahit medyo event ka walang siya, doon mo mas naging clear kasi siya for me to differentiate na. Does, let's say, as height increases, does weight increase also? Or does it decrease? Also, if they do increase at the same time, does weight increase by a big number or not necessarily a big number? Which eventually leads you, covariance sa data, so add ulit na lahat. Then we divide all of n or n minus 1, n being this one, not the sum of the two. Ano ba napansin nito? Let's say I have 7 theta point here and only 6 here. Pwede ba ako mag-covariance in there? Hindi. Kasi you're trying to compare and contrast now. So tip lang din yun. For thesis, for any research, when you want to covariance, make sure, kasi usually ang covariance naman would be two particular measures of certain characteristics. What do you mean by characteristics? Let's say a person. Characteristics of a person would be height, weight, waistline, what size, whatever. Kung ilang people ang minesure mo, ganun karaming height ang minesure ko, ganun karaming weight ang minesure ko, etc. So when you do your thesis, when you do your study, whatever, you do covariance, make sure equal data points set because they all link to one person, could be one company, could be one yung relevance na covariance. So to get correlation, di ba kanina madali si variance kung standard deviation? So, correlation madali lang naman yun. Pero after you get a covariance, ito, regards to n minus 1, you divide that by, compute for the standard deviation here, and then the standard deviation here, all over, may standard deviation ka ng data set one, and then standard deviation. Product. Yes. What will happen is product. X times y meter squared, diba? Ito meter squared. Pag i-divide ko, wala na units ko, diba? It's gonna be that with what? Ako efficient. In the expanded unit less siya. Correlations will always be a value from, not necessarily, a value from negative 1 to 1. It's telling you how strong they are related to each other. And it will tell you if it's in the same direction or not. Kung positive or negative siya, positive, same direction sila bumaba. Kung bumaba, yung isa bababa, yung isa. Vice versa. Pag negative siya, as one goes up, the other goes down. If their correlation is, let's say, 0.2 versus a correlation of something that's 0.9, 0.9 means, as I move 1 meter, let's say, forward, the person sa kakabi ko, mga 0.9 meter. Pero, if 0.2 lang correlation, as in 1 meter forward sa 0.2 lang, ibig sabihin, hindi ganun ka strong yung influence namin sa isa't isa. Siguro, ang thing din to watch out for dito, para hindi rin kaya matira sa ano, kasi medyo powerful na, pero hindi kaya matira sa thesis is, when you say correlation, it does not mean causality. One does not cause the other. It just shows you a certain pattern behavior of how numbers move, na most likely ganito rin yung pag-alaman. Kasi it's possible na let's say yung correlation ng economy ng Philippines versus number of snake bites in the jungle. Kung sino man as correlation nila, they just occur suddenly at the same rate. But they do not have any relationship to each other, diba? Yung parang ganun. So be careful lang. Usually you back up your correlations with studies, with conceptual frameworks, with controlled environments and theories. Ganyan. So doon lang kayo maging careful sa correlation. Don't worry pagdating ng stat course nyo. Kaya sa pagtuturo sa inyo, logic din those would be more, again, not necessarily masanity, but they're more powerful in determining and telling you what could most likely happen, what is the, how strong is the relationship. First of all, thesis na yung ko ngayon for using statistics. So, very useful. Okay. Wala nang kanto, sorry, sa covariance. Ah, ang practical niya, siguro ano, regression. But it's medyo high level stat. Huh? I'd let the stat prof na lang teach that kasi pag kinakapang kasalo sa correlation yung mas important. Covariance most likely lead to the health benefit. In finance, actually, so yun naman si covariance. Have you heard of beta? Have you heard of beta? Beta is how the stock index it's a covariance of your stock to the market movement divided by the variance of the market that is going down. It is you, how closely related that stock is to the market. So let's say yung beta ko is, let's say, 2 times the market. Ibig sabihin, sobrang nagpa-fluctuate yung stock covers to the market. So usually, ganun ang mga applications ng covariance. Right now, I'm using covariance din sa, okay, here.
If positive covariance, positive correlation, negative covariance, negative correlation.
Yes. But it changes. Standard deviations are always positive, positive. So yung covariance mo, kung positive divided by positive, what the positive? Negative divided by positive. That deviation is always positive. Any other questions? You can go through the exam, take one final na lang. Pero, it might take a lot of time. I'd rather focus on probability to tell you, or more of it. Let's go to probability. Let's try to go through it. Then, when we have time, additional questions. Pero concept at least pa clear ka. Mas importante mag-grasp natin yung where. SD that is variant. Bloated C variant. Yeah. Parang you just have to know what you're using. If it's in variant sa square, different distance. Pag sa SD that is square. Okay. Parang nag-manufacture ako ng laptops. Insert din, dapat yung mga microchips, whatever ko sa loob, hindi lang insert pa. So, kaya naman rin po, school is where pa siya. Tapos eventually, may desertification, it's gonna be back to the left. It's more of you understanding. Hindi na siya yung lang yun. Parang yung understanding, ano yung measure mo? Gano? Yung correct quality assurance ako. Ano ba yung measure ko? Gaano kalayo? Gaano kalaki ba yung difference ko from dapat 10 minutes ako sa 10 point pagka may telephone ka. Variances usually, hindi mo kaisip na mo sobrang kakya at yung gating for variances actually. So you need to go through solving for variances and attend the TV. Would it be
like to
explain for
the total difference
Part B, concept ko lang is kung naka-square ka kasi naka-area ka. Yes. If you're going that nag-a-analyze ka, naka-analyze ka. Variant siguro is how fluctuating it is. Standard deviation is how far ahead from each other. If that makes more sense. Medyo very technical lang siya, so I'm not sure okay din ano. Pero yun lang, so far from my experience naman, the reason for me is only for variance that means certain things have to occur. Either to get a standard deviation or finance. Okay. Kung makikita nila yung Gilbert. Kasi yung mag-break na for probability or kind of thriller. My first question. Rather than the middle median, alam niyo na how to upper median na dito. So, what do you get the median again? Yeah. So, that's it. Okay. So, this is why you know, formula.
We have this thing like, for the tests.
Oh.
Like, it could be recorded for us. Is it probability or? Okay. You were saying you were going to share.
It's amazing. Well, sa akin kasi from my experience, sa mga index na ito, sa TTK, basta mo na-take yung test mo. Parang ipuhin natin din. Sige, kung ayun yung wala naman, sakto rin, I think I'll move to probabilities na lang. So probabilities, baka mo yung okay na kayo yung final exam. Kahit i-go through one. Or kahit i-preliminary na lang, sorry, yung preliminary exam na lang. Yung pre-test na lang i-go through one sa probability later. Para yung final exam, wala spoilers or whatever. Tapos, yung
go back.
Hindi yung question na kung point analytic class letter is yung kung hindi mo ka na-take for debate for the edge minus of trying to go through the whole thing.
Yeah, but I don't think you're gonna go through all the questions
that you need
tonight. So,
yes.
If you're
going
to answer some of them, then
please
put them
on the board. And then you will already answer your own question. Actually, that's the question why I asked if you guys took it. Kasi doon natin malalaman, ano yung questions na yung sobrang hirap. Hindi lang sana i-discuss ko. Pero, actually, ito na lang part of my plan din. Kasi usually, what other people usually think there is a technical side, which you can Google or you can do the app. That's important. That's important.
I think you're going to have another session.
Very good point, Jana. At least I can think, since may isa pang session, I can guide you guys conceptually first. Malapit to this. I'll give you tools, more of tools rather than answers. Kasi parang malilig yung first point. And at the same time, sa Thursday, kung may kayo masagot, parang kayo kasi sa mahirap na yung day after day, I'll try to answer your question. I'll do my best to answer naman your reading. So, disclaimer lang, I'm not a staff or probability maker. So, So I'll be focused on how to make it more practical and easy. I'll go to probability na muna para at least makover ko yung foundations ninyo. So regardless if you finish or not tonight, in terms of answering certain questions or whatever, kaya nyo na sagutin until my third grade year. Okay. Probability, ito yung subject din namin dahil sa engineering na 70% ng class yung mag-work up. So, yun like, nag-guess ko rin na you guys think you're going to pick up. Preferring technical metrics training or yung parang science na nakapunin ko. Because this is like, event sample spaces and experiments by probability. When you say probability. Okay. For probability, think of it always as you want to know what percentage or what is the likelihood something will happen. That's why you're solving for it. The essence of solving for probability is because if you make this difficult, you have to know what's the likelihood of something will happen. To a forecasting model, I think sales will happen, but I'm only 20% confident here. It's 80% confident ako na status quo. How are you able to measure your decision point so that you can plan out your resources kaya niyong balancing yung both. Parang ganun. You're trying to determine what is the likelihood. It's all chance. It's a way of showing a number. It's a way of showing a certain percentage to you. But ultimately, it's up to you to decide on what to do with it. Statistics and probability will both be under one force because magkaka-overlap siya. They begin with that to determine certain probability also. So mag-overlap siya so that you have a little bit of science for this one. And then, well from my experience, it will be in a practical application, it's more relatable. So hindi siya yung sobrang-hyperting as a number siya. They give you scenarios always. They give you applications so that you understand why it happens this way. And in a way, when you say probability, it's also the same as in stats called confidence interval. Why is it important to the concept of probability? I have a certain 95% confidence interval. That is usually the research golden number for some reason. But 95% confidence interval, if you pass it, then most likely it's true. So you're trying to play with numbers in a way that you want to generate what is certain from which it's not. So basic scenarios muna try ko ito sa inyo. And then, personally kasi for me yung if it's mutually exclusive or not, complementary or not. Hindi siya sobrang relevant kasi mahirap i-memorize in terms of if it's going to be mutually exclusive, going to be complementary to it. We don't necessarily need that. You need to understand na what are you supposed to do when given two scenarios. For example, I draw a card in a... Sorry, lahat mo kami sa video. If I draw a card and I get an ace, I put it back, I shuffle, probability I get a 2 versus I draw a card, I get an ace, I put it aside, and then I draw another card, so probability I get a 2. For me, most importantly, you know how to solve separately those two scenarios rather than kung natapos sa kanina, at least for now. Kasi hindi naman siya maging given sa'yo sa applicants. Okay? Tapos you can read up on the lang if you want me to use a complementary. Let's see. May two dice kayo. Madala kayo na yun. I use graphic examples na kasi hindi ko siya dito. If I ask you, what is the probability I would roll what's the probability I would roll a 4 or a 6? How did you get that? When you notice my scenario, I said 4 at the top. It could mean one happened or the other happened. So any of the two happened in the scenario. When you notice my scenario, I said 4 at the top. It could mean one happened or the other happened. So any of the two happened in the scenario. What is the probability that I will roll? Is the problem I will roll a 4 on the first die, and then a 4 on the first die, but the total value of my 2 dice after is 8 or greater. What is the probability na 4 yung first die ko, tapos yung total value niya is 4 or greater? So you have to break it down. Like what you did kanina, iisip mo muna, what's the chance to get a 4? What's the chance to get a 6? So what's the chance I will get a 4? The first day. When I first day is 4 levels and 6, diba? And then the sum of the two dice have to be 8 or greater. So ano number is yun? 4, 5, 6. 4 kasama, yes or no? 4, 5, 6. Probability I will get a 5 or a heart. Okay. Probability of getting a 5 is what?
4 over 52.
Good. Gusto yung ginagawa niya na daritong huwag mo lang i-simplify. You'll see why later. 4 over 52. This is 5. Or a heart. What's the probability of a heart? 13 over 50. What do I do? Add. Kasi or yun ha. So, bakit 6 of hearts? Pasado pa rin. 5 of diamonds, pasado pa rin. So, you add. But, meron pa ako dapat gawin dito. Is this all your scenarios? 5 of hearts, 5 of spades, 5 of diamonds, 5 of clubs. 8 of hearts, 2 of hearts, 3 of hearts, 4 of hearts, 5 of hearts. And double it off that. So be careful sa mga ganyan. Okay? Pero same yung content you're supposed to add when they're not dependent on each other. Let's say the question is, I have to draw a face card and a diamond. How many face cards are there in the deck? How many diamonds are there in the deck? 13 out of 2. So, actually, you can count it, alam ko, para mas mudali. What I will do sa ganyan, kahit i-multiply 12 times or divide by 50. Kung same ang dalawa sa basically, diba ilang parts mo sa life? 52, diba? Technically, you only have 8 billion half times sa pwede to 1 second. So, yung isang strategy to know, if one is dependent on the other, I multiply. If they're not dependent on each other, I add, then I subtract redundancy. Okay? Do you think it would be better if you get other samples? Para at least ma-natin natin. Okay. Sige. I think I'll just go through mabilis lang ito. Yung complementary events. Then after that, I'll go through some questions. And then after that, later, I'll go through the random variables. Random variables is where stat and probabilities are coming. Yun yung medyo naging complicated. First question is, where is this? Okay. Suppose that the dice is tossed 3 times, what's the probability at least 1/6 will be tossed? There is a way to follow this. Pero sinabi ba at least 1/6? I said kanina as a complementary. Kasi pwede siyang strategy. Complementary is the exact opposite. Or let's say you have a 30% probability. The complementary of that is 70%. Kung alam niyo, 1/3 chance ka, complementary is 30. Why is this important? Specific for this scenario. We can solve for the chance that only 1/6 will be tossed, 2/6 will be tossed, 3/6 will be tossed. But what we can also solve for, what is the probability that no 6 will be tossed at all, that 1 minus that. Diba? So, for example, what is the probability that the first dice will be tossed and then it's not 6? 5/6, diba? Second dice, level of 6. And then the last dice is 5/6. These are the complements. I'm just introducing you the complement as a strategy right again at the beginning kasi po si Pinto na daming scenario siya ni Kofi-Ken. Yung first dice mo 6, tapos the rest hindi. Second dice is 6, the third dice is pwede. For 2 dice is a person. Second, third person. Ang pulo. We gotta do this na lang. So I add multiply. Multiply because they depend on each other. Kasi ito yung na no 6 is will happen. The dice before this, kailangan hindi na 6. Multiply. Then the dice before this, kailangan hindi ulit. So when you multiply it all together, 125/16. Now, complement what did I say is 1-. So you completed for the scenario na walang dice sa labas. Meaning, everything else, sigurado kami, walang dice sa labas, walang 6 sa labas. So you're sure that the difference is at least 1/6 of a probability. So 216 minus 125 is 91. Sorry if bagsak dito. This was yung start pala ng MBA. Yung kasi yung last year pa rin. Baka wala kayo yung DDT ko bigla. Okay, ito. This is important. Ito yung isa ginagita niya sa mga IT test natin.
Or yung mga IT test.
Okay. Suppose that 10% of all students play a winter sport. Okay, then 20% plays a spring sport and 5% play both. Tanan yung example kanina. 5 and hurts, diba? At least yung tools na lang daw to help people. How many fights are there? 4. How many hearts? 13. How many care? How many do they care? 1, diba? Or 30. That's how you're supposed to look at this problem also. Because we both the bank care. You can allow 10% though. Tama. Tapos 10% winter. 5% though. Winter is how many percent? 10? That's 20. 10 minus 5. 20 minus 5. So the question is, what is the probability that a randomly chosen student plays a winter or a spring sport? What does 4 mean again? Parang kanina yun ako, 5 or hearts. 4 plus 30 minus 1. Or parang 3 plus 1 plus 1. Parang ganun din siya. Parang 10 plus 20 minus 5. Pwede ka tasok ko. Nakakaya ko yun. Okay, 25. Good. Sorry, here ba? Probabilities can be also using this better. Mas madali ito for you to picture. There is a situation talaga that you would rather. It is a probability graphic. Hindi siya sobrang delicate. And the difficulty talaga. Centering is yung mga tools na nangyayari. Both the two types are costs that either show some 4, 5, or 6. What is the probability that the total sum of 2 dice is 6? Right, that's simple. Suppose 2 dice are costs and either shows some 4, 5, or 6. Usually, ang sinasabi na nyan sa'yo is, I am already sure na hindi siya 4, 5, or 6. So ano na lang choices mo sa 2 dice? 1, 2, or 3. What is the probability that the total sum of 2 dice is 6? So dahil 1, 2, or 3 na lang siya, yung mga sum na lang pwede yung 6 is 1. 1, 2, or 3 lang siya. So 1 plus 1 is not 6, plus 2 is not 6, 3 plus 3 lang, diba? So only 1 is not siya. Which means your 2 dice have to be 3 and 3. And, diba? Kaya 1 is 5. Kaya 1 is 9. The longer way of showing this, para at least may illustrate, kasi not necessarily everyone will understand yung supposed that 2 of the dice are, diba? What you can do here is, what is the probability na sum ko is 6? Tapos, kahit pag muna isipin yung ano, kahit pag muna isipin yung 9 na. What is the probability na sum is 6 pag less than, ano siya, pag less than, less than 4, 5, or 6 siya? One scenario pa rin siya, diba? Okay lang muna kahit, parang ano lang, same situation, pero wala yung supposed two dice or cost, and then neither dice or 5, 6. Assume mo lang na, what is the probability that the total sum of the two dice is 6. Tapos, total is 6, pero bawal sa pawal ng at p plus p lang yun, diba? So yung, pag ko na rin yung question ko, what's the probability that the total is 6, pero bawal akong magulang ng 4, 5, and 6? Ganyan yung how to solve it, diba? There's only one instance, kasi 3 plus 3 lang siya, na 6. Kasi anything else, kailangan mo na lang 4, 2, 5, 1. Kaya wala akong 36 sa dito. When you say supposed kasi this, it means this is your probability given a certain event. So let's say the event is dito, supposed that it doesn't go 4, 5, and 6 na. So what are the instances na hindi siya lalabas as 4, 5, and 6? So that, so that's 3 times 3. One, two, or three, though. One, two, or three, though. Nawala ako na ba kayo, sorry. Kasi yung gusto ko yung pakita is hindi yung ganito siya. Yung gusto ko yung pakita. Pero another way you can look at it is... Oh, mas graphical kayo. There are 36 possible instances. Okay. Parang ito lang yung instances mo na parang ito yung instances mo na at least one of the dice that you throw is 4 or above. Na dito yung instances, lahat, ito yung lahat ng instances mo. This 27. Yung 9 na tayo sa'yo sabi niya, this is the instances na 1, 2, 3 na malalabas lagi yung both dice. There will be 9 multiple Yung question is, what the sum siya of 6, but no number is greater than 3. That will only happen once, di ba? If I did not say supposed that the population of that, you would solve this one out of 36. Pero, you're trying to ask, what is the probability na, well, for at least percentage or whatever, na yun yung lalabas, pag sure ka na ito yung lalabas, ito yung result mo. Kaya 1 divided by 9. Sorry, mas clear ba ito? Or mahirap na rin? This will, I think, help you guys out. Okay. Pwede ko kayong shopping? Girls, pwede ko kayong shopping? Okay, let's kayo. Anong favorite subjects mo? Matalang mo. Kapabili. Keep it as nothing. Sa mga boys, sino mahilig sa English? Oh, ano mo mahilig kayo sa English? Awan! At kasi kayo na naman probability. So ngayon, girls, sino mahilig sa English? Okay na, okay. Turo ko sa inyo na ito, baka sa natin. There are 3 boys and 3 girls. There are 2 people of the like probability. There are 4 people who like English. End of the day, kailangan 6-5 po tayo nila, regardless. I think this would be the same, kasi maganda yung question ni Sean. Yung, bakit kailangan natin divide? Pag tinanong ko, how many girls are there? out of the total population. What do you do? Total girls, yeah, 6. How many girls are there that like English out of the total population? 3 out of 6, I'm sure we'll need a 5. Ito, diba? Girls that like English, 3 out of 5. Parang ganun yung kanina. How many total song na 6? How many total song na 6 na 1 to 3 na pwede? You're getting a part of the pool. Now to your question, what if I ask, how many boys are there? What's the probability that if a person likes English, the person's a boy? Suppose it the person likes English, boy siya. 1 out of 4, not 1 out of 6. Yun din dito. Instead of 1 out of 36, 1 out of 9 na. Kasi kinasum mo na kaagad. May issue sa English. Gawin itong matrix from powerful ito. Powerful ito. So yun. So, kahit anong question ko na iba to sa inyo, tila mo sa sagot. Sige, Paul. What's the probability that a person likes, a person is a boy? A person is a boy, given or given that the person likes probability. Over to 100%. Kasi given that probability, sure ka na gusto niya probability, ilang percent na lang ang boy? Kyle, how many, given that the person is a girl, sure ka girl siya, ilang percent ang gusto niya probability? Zero. Zero out of given the girl. Kaya sa ilan ang may gusto ng English out of the whole population? Or out of? Nasabot nila lahat ang pwede family of questions. So, use this na lang. Kasi, ang hirap to explain ng ganito. Ang hirap siya kung kinakapar nila. So, I just use this na lang. So that you guys also probably decent for your skin. I'll go to a difficult question para you to appreciate this. Hindi pa nakita ang question ganyan ito sa exam. Magbabaliw na ako. Any question? Medyo overwhelming siya. For me, at least. Hindi ko lang sa'yo ako sa baling. Ako, itong una din kasi I'm not sure what to call. So even if you're not sure how to solve it, try to take the union tabular na lang. Okay? What are the situations? Disease or not? Positive or not? Yun ang naman, diba? So you just try to capture the kundali dito. I try to capture all the scenarios. All the boys that like English, all the boys that like problems. So basically, yun ang okay, diba? To capture all the scenarios. Yun ang talagang gagawin na dito. As you read the problem, try to plot it to be able to fill out it up. So you're sure that there is either a disease or no disease, positive or negative. Suppose that 1% of all people have a particular disease. 1% of all people. Saan ko dapat nilalagay yun? 1% of all people have disease. Yep. Sa lahat ng people to. I don't care if you tested positive or negative. It's 1% of all people have disease. Kesa na dito, ask yourself lagi, relevant ba ang positive and negative sa statement? Yun? If not, then. Next is, a test for the disease is 99% accurate. This means that a person who has a disease has a 99% chance of testing positive. So out of that 1%, what's 99% of this? 99%. I'm a 0.99% of testing positive. Kasi sure ako na may disease na siya eh. Ilang percent ang positive. So ito, automatically. Yeah. 0.01% ka. Kasi kailangan mag add up yan. Ilang percent to? Yes, because 99, it's the same, diba? Complemented. If 1% of total population has a disease, 99% walang disease. Siguro. Okay. While a person who doesn't have the disease has a 99% chance of testing negative. So if a person has no disease, the chance of testing negative is 1%. 99% of what? 99%. So we add this here. This is now is, if a person tests positive for the disease, what is the chance? Parang if you're gonna positive ka, diba? So, come on. It's 99%. Okay, that's it. First question ko is, pwede na kayo kami kumamit ng CPA ko rin dito? Not yet. Kasi yun yung random, pati yung random variable and distributed variable. Okay. Hindi ko muna prepare yung table, baka part siya na ng concept share, whatever for the history. Pero, data sets are normally distributed. The value of getting a standard deviation is this. So now you solve for standard deviation and then the data that I see. So now you solve for this. What, quite a midpoint. One standard deviation to the left or to the right. Around 34%. Meaning, if your data, meaning if I ask you, average that. Let's say, sweldo ng mga AI graduates after matapos ang program. Dito reflect, di ba? Yung ito tingin rin for it, example. Kaya sweldo nila monthly is around 150,000. Titingnan ko sinong yung sweldo. Mukhang wala. Okay. So, kung tanong yung rin point yung 150,000, your standard deviation, let's say, is pero sinulad nyo kanina, okay, ano yung mean, ito yung mean natin, ito yung sobrang daming data set nyo. And then yung mas naming distributed. Ano nga yung probability or whatever? Question 6 or D are being asked na what is the probability that my salary, let's say, is from 120 to 180,000. Sabi ko kanina na standard deviation is 1, diba? 1 standard deviation or 1 times your standard deviation is 1 to your left and 1 to your right. So, 150 minus 30, 150 plus 30, new range from here to here, diba? 150, 120, 80. I can actually say, this is my data. Ano yung balance of probability is that? I can say I'm 68% sure MBA graduate from AIM salary is from 120 to 180,000 pesos given the data. That's the probability value. Tapos, research. Research usually 95% confidence interval, diba? Para lang automatic agad sa inyo, it's usually 2 times your standard deviation. The exact number is around 1.96. Pero parang 2 na rin halos yun. So, 2 times your standard deviation is 50,000, diba? 90,000 ka, lowest value, highest value mo, 10. Ganito yung difference niya. If I ask you, give me a range where you're 95% sure you fell ng mga AIM graduates. That's from 90 to 210. Because 13.5 plus 13.5 is 27. 27 plus 6 is 89%. That's why it's called confidence interval. Because this is how confident you are your data is within that certain range that you just mentioned. So if I ask you, ang patas na nalang dito is sabi natin mga 2.5% na lang ito, diba? If I ask you, what is the probability that the salary of an AIM graduate student is higher than 210? 2.5. Higher lang kasi ito. If I said lower than 90 or higher than 210, ano din ang or? Add subtracted. Add. What is the probability that the salary of an AIM student is from 150 to 210? These are what we call empirical values, empirical numbers, meaning 1 standard deviation, 2 standard deviation. May 3 standard deviation, that's around 99. So this is for now lang, din around pa lang siya. Pero when you go to sa talaga, it's not 2, it's 1.96. Kasi when you get to solving for Z table na, eventually, it will tell you ano yung exact value niya. So of course, yung standard deviation mo. That's actually what you solve for in the Z test. Hindi ko lang kung ituturo ako ito. The number you solve for in the Z test is what you try to multiply to your standard deviation. Meaning, how many standard deviations away you did. So the higher the Z value is, the more it is towards here or towards there. Because it's the distance from this one. But ano sa deviation mo dito? Sa midpoint niyo. is 0. Ito, standard deviation is 30, diba? One standard deviation. 150, ano standard deviation niya? To itself.
0.
Kaya siya, midpoint. Kasi, you don't multiply by anything, hindi ka lumalay. So, yung concept ng random variable distribution, it's basically trying to see some statistics. Tinatry ko, i-lay out yung insurance. Sino ang nasa gitna, sino ang nasa left, sino ang right, gaano karalayo sila. Kasi, for example, ito pala ha, sa deviation ko, let's say 60,000 pala. Even if this was my midpoint, suddenly, ito yung bagong 34% ko. This is where dito na makita yung value in business din. Na just because you make points at the same, doesn't mean you can say something very confident depending on the size of the standard deviation. It's not the larger the standard deviation, the bigger the range you have to give for you to say that I'm 95% confident within the error data. The smaller the standard deviation. Yun yung measure kanina of variability. So, ganun din. The bigger the standard deviation, the bigger than the range you have to say to be a certain percentage of the okay. I suggest talaga go through yung mga random variables sa time condition, eventually on your own time, then try and take the exercises. Kasi mas magandang tayo sa better foundation of it, saka I know which questions I can answer. Kasi hindi ko alam ngayon what you know. Parang you don't know what you know. So, unless matry nyo siya, doon yung malalaman which concept am I having hard time absorbing, which question am I having hard time absorbing. Go through questions, right, and be related. I think okay lang din naman. This is your first day. Okay. So, you want to do the diagram ito. Kasi pag formula pinigay sa inyo, baka then on the stat class, MRR, your calculator. Sometimes, that's why I'm more of medium din ang video of what you're solving for. Kasi when you do your research, parang, computer, microprogramming ka? Okay. Okay, information systems. I'm gonna be an example. Sabi natin nag-implement ka ng information system sa Jollibee. Service line nila dati, sabihin natin. Sorry, I'm trying to think of real time kasi parang updated pa ko. Kunwari, 8 seconds. Time for me to serve the customer. Standard deviation ko, let's say, is 0.5 seconds. Nagkita ka eh. If you're a restaurant, you can test it. Nagkita, time study, check mo, okay, gano'n ka, business ko mag-serve yung customer. Hindi naman siya lang 8 seconds. 7.4, 7.8, 9.2, whatever. Kung na yung average of 8, that yung deviation mo, after you solve for it. So you know 8 is here. Diba? One standard deviation is 7.5 and 2 standard deviation is 7 to 9. So, hindi ka parang maliging natin. 7 to 9. Okay? pag nag-implement ka ng program, ng information system, bigla, ano ba yung goal lang ka nag-implement ng information system? Kung na your goal mo sa speed of the process, hindi lang para lang ka-effect tayo. Kailangan yung point siya. Why can you draw in the business? So, let's say, implement na yung process. Tapos, naging time mo is 7.2 seconds. Malang ka improvement mo. It's standard deviation mo is 0.5. Baka hindi masyado. Because 0.5, 7.5 is your one standard deviation. 7.2 is over here. This is 24%. Sorry, you are the 24 plus 50. You're 84% fast, confident that you are faster than before. Kasi half, the 24. So it's over here. Versus, let's say, your result mo is 95 records. Times 3 na, 0.5 times 3 is 1.5. 5 seconds. So it's sobrang outlier yun yan, diba? So kahit gaano maraming data points ako, I'm only, parang 99% sure lahat ng data in the world, kung walang information system, this range lang, mga 6.5 lang. But your information system made it 5 seconds. That's how you can justify na sobrang laki improvement ng data ko. In your thesis or capsule or whatever, ganito yung mangyayari. How can you justify using data that ganito na kalaki ang naging impact mo, ang study mo, ganito nga laking impact kung whatever this problem is. Yun yung na-appreciate ko sa more on stat rather than probability. Probability naman, ini-invent na siya. Parang yun, technically loss probability na yun, is ilan percent. Pero mas make sure of code siya. That's why anyone for that stat probability. It's called manager yun. So maraming subjects mas volunteer ko dito kasi pag sa MRR kaya ako MRR. Any other questions? But at least yung for now na siguro kasi may Thursday FOP kasi I'll cross through the questions nila lang with which ones yung nahirap talaga, what concepts are to grasp kasi if parang hindi kaya sa 2 hours yung hindi ko natin summarize as fast as possible yung at least yung signals. Then, any other questions? Kahit na MBA questions, okay lang naman yung mga content. Okay, hi, ha? Thank you.
pasok, dito ka, diba? May counter in this line, yung gas ka. Basta ka doon kaya second market yung gas, yung required number. So, first pair of basic, second pair of basic. Pwede pala mo siya sabihin, okay, because of this at, ito yung study yung na-implement ko kasi pinansin yung guys yung situation nila, but yun din ako, consumer insight. Gano'n lang dito sa sabi. Na, ka, ano siya, tapos, that way, kasi, magkakaroon kayo na eventually aral yung predictive analysis. So, kumari, sa 30 customer, ayan, let's say 2,000 customer. So, bumili ako ng product, yung product na yun sa product yung at the end of the MVP, so, na yung bago customer. Ano yung first yung product na bilhin niya? Because may data ako before, kasi, most likely, aral ko yan yung device ko para maka-upsell mo siya. Just marketing person. Para at least mag-get siya na pag-get siya na task ko magagamit na siya. Nag-robotics ako talaga. Tapos, ano ba kayo din yun? Kailan sa bed ito? Ay, yung number? Kulay na ko. Ano na yun? Manufacturing robotics, tapos supply chain ako yung tapos now, hindi ASN ako sa pag-construction. Pwede na mag-first sa video. And I found out na tulong ko. Malaking tulong talaga ang first video ko smart. Pero mas mahalaga yung parang bare minimum nga yung kailangan okay ka naman yung comfortable ka. Comfortable ka rin dapat sa Excel. Kasi ask ka rin yun. Comfortable ka sa Excel. Then eventually, pag natunan natin yung mga ibang project, hindi ka ba? Numbers are given na dapat natin yung ibang project. Then parang in-expect na tama yung numbers yung given niya nyo. Mag-recommend na kayo sa paper din yung mga ibang scientific calculator can save your life during exams kung bago mo kayo. Kasi accounting, ganun siya. Kung may mga kapat ko yung mag-selected para mag-calculator, yung hindi na tumitingin, kung fit na lang ganun, para mag-selected. Okay lang yun. Nakikita ko yun sa mga klase ko, nakakatakot siya. Kung magalaw yung grade table, wala pa rin. Pero ako, pag scientific calculator kasi, ma-review ko pa yung mga sinet ko ba, ito yung number sa mga klase. So ako, parang active. Ayoko din na meron mga iba. Ayoko, why I'm trying to give it. Ayoko na experience yung baka tumunta kayo bumabakay dito. Just because of stupid stuff like that. Now, my point is, scientific calculator is limited. Pwede na nung example na. Basta hindi pwede mag-store ng formula sa inyo. Pero hindi ko alam yung sinyo ba magpapay-ban na scientific calculator. If we do, hindi ko nag-examine. Or just give